I guess this. It's four of them, obviously. I like this font. Ooh,
once
I get a little thing.
A thriving tribal civilization, the Minmatar were enslaved by the Amar Empire for hundreds of years. Most were freed after a great rebellion, but only at a tremendous cost. Today, the Minmatar Republic is a strong, resurgent nation, determined to win back the glory of its past.
We'll go with it. Few minutes to load stuff, huh? Now we got three things to pick from here. Wait, little punk rockers. Oh, geez. Takes a few minutes to load, but why not? See this? What is that? What? I'm gonna go back to this one. Give him a battle scar right on his eye. Hello, ghost. Come back. Continue. Guess he can't go naked, since. He really needs glasses. How can I go? I can't. Eve Online. I've never played it, so I figured I'd give it a old college try. Click random a few times. Hello, Micah. I like it. Be corny. Ken, we could be corny, guys. Gotta do it. Yep. Windows Defender. Now access. Space.
Calling any convoy Talon Alpha 5 survivors. Come in, all survivors. Tracking an active training corvette. What is your status? Recruit, wake up and respond. Damn it. Recruit, do you remember anything from the attack?
No.
Did you see the drifter swarm warp in and gut your fleet?
Oh.
Feel panic and fear as ships burned all around you. I imagine you remember at least that. Well, keep a lid on that for now. Recruit, my name is Fleet Commander Vidari, and from this point on, you will consider me your commanding officer. Now, we need to figure this situation out.
Odd-looking ship.
I'm lifting your training restrictions and giving you access to your ship's onboard AI. This is Aura, a powerful ally. She'll help you get your ship moving.
Gurkhas.
Greetings, Captain. I am Aura. I will assist you in commanding your vessel and navigating New Eden. My core logic library has been proven to increase the odds of survival by several orders of magnitude.
Nice.
But I am only capable of advising you. You must make decisions for yourself. Simulations have proven that situational awareness is key to survival.
We're dead.
I will now demonstrate how to become aware and alert. Captain, if you close my comms window for any reason, you will be able to recall it through the operations info panel by clicking Aura Tips. When you're ready to continue, click Next.
Ready.
To orbit the view around your ship, hold...
I got that.
To zoom in or out, let's test basic navigation functions.
Please zoom out.
According to my logs, a Titan-type capital ship in your fleet was destroyed. It would be useful to locate that ship's wreckage and start navigating towards it. A Titan should be the biggest shipwreck that you will be able to find. To set a course for your ship, double-click your mouse's left button anywhere in space.
Well, that's
to stop your ship, you should click the highlighted stop button. Using these functions will help you explore the site. Exploration is a vital trait.
What in the name? Are you serious? My logs are saying you haven't even graduated from the Academy Flight School yet. Okay, we'll make this work even if you're all I've got. You're gonna have to start right now. My scans are showing more life signs near your location. Your convoy included transports with important research scientists. Given their work, if they were to be picked up by drifter scavengers, it would be a nightmare for the Republic. So check the wrecks for potential survivors.
I guess these are the wrecks. Go to that.
Captain, I have received faint signals from 3 survivors. To help determine the location of the signal, you should use the look and approach functions of your ship to get closer. Being close will allow you to see what's inside each wreck.
Beautiful.
To focus see your ghost. Camera on a piece of wreckage,
it is on Steam, yep.
Right-click
hello,
on
teamed.
The wreckage and select the look at command. Look at is great for inspecting objects in space, but not for piloting. To reset your view, right-click in space and select look at my ship. Next, right-click on the wreckage and select the approach command. We need to get close to the wreckage to extract the survivors, but remember to stop your ship when you are beside the wreckage.
Oops. Please don't crash. Hit stop, right? I think I crashed into it. I don't know if that counts. I'm back, HD. This is the records they're talking about, soon. No, this is probably what they're talking about. Yep.
To transfer everything from their cargo hold to your own, move your mouse pointer over the wreckage and hold down the left mouse button. A radial menu will appear. Select Open Cargo to view the contents, and then press the Loot All button.
I think I crashed into it again. Cool.
After you have clicked the Loot All button, you should close the inventory window using the X in the corner. I'm receiving signals that indicate the next survivor is located in the highlighted wreckage. Right-click on the...
Right-click on what?
To transfer the next survivor to your ship, you should repeat the same steps as before.
I think we can do that.
Move your mouse pointer over the wreckage and hold down the left mouse button. A radial menu will appear. Select Open Cargo to view the contents and then press the
Delete All
button.
What's the name of this game? EVE Online. Alright, stop before you crash. Alright, where's the last one?
Excellent, Captain. My scanners indicate one more survivor. You should now transfer the last survivors to your ship.
Working on
Don't
it.
Forget to close the inventory windows after you have finished.
What happens if I don't? Is there a shortcut for stop? I guess not. Speed ahead. A scientist and 2 survivors.
Captain.
Good.
I am Professor Tannen from the Sisters of EVE research team. Thank you for saving my life.
The attack was complete carnage. Thousands were killed.
This is like Chad, I guess?
Our research on drifter strikes indicates they will likely return to this location to retrieve any survivors. And not for good. I believe the drifters want those survivors for invasive information extraction. It's very invasive. Such information is classified and of great value to the Empire, but since my survival depends on you, I am entrusting you with this.
Recruit, I thought you'd be a cloud of hot gas by now, and instead here you are holding on to my top research scientist. I'll tell you something that strictly need to know. Those researchers you just rescued may have vital data on the source of the ongoing drifter invasion, a drifter hive. One of these hives, inside Minmatar Republic space, constitutes an existential threat. As such, it's now of the highest urgency to get you and your vessel home safely.
Let's go.
Unfortunately, the drifters will want to carve your ship open, grab anyone
it's in the title, HD.
Alive, and take them to their hive. We don't know what happens in them, but if you end up in one, you can forget about seeing your tribe again. You should get moving, but there's a problem. You probably didn't realize the drifters have deployed some kind of warp bubble around your location. That stops you from warping away. Fortunately, they're not magicians, and the field generator is close by. Locate it, destroy it, and get the hell out of there.
Field generator. All right.
Captain, in your ship's overview, you can see what your ship's scanners are picking up around you. Find your warp disruption generator.
Found it.
To lock your weapon system on the generator, hold down your left mouse button on the generator and select Lock Target on the radial menu.
I should stop approaching it.
While engaging, the optimal flight path is to orbit your target. This enables you to move while firing, making it difficult for your enemy's weapon systems to track you. Move your mouse over the generator and hold down the left mouse button to open the radial menu. Excellent. You are in the optimal position.
Thanks, man.
I suggest you fire your primary weapon.
How do I do this? Even hitting it? Guess
you
so.
Now stop your ship.
That's one floor on your side removed, but it's not over yet. I can see that the drifters deployed a second warp bubble. They must be very eager to add you to their trophy cabinet. Looks like you have to. Oh, wait. Okay. You'll have to pause that, recruit. You're about to get a chance to prove you have a place with us, defending the tribes. You have a drifter seeker on grid, just dropped out of warp, and you need to take it out. Aura, our recruit needs a crash course on gunnery. They're no use to me dead.
Captain? Now it's time to engage your weapons, Captain.
Firing. Ooh. Got a weapon too? Can we shoot that? Nope. That. Afterburner.
Don't forget to stop your ship.
Did it.
For a rookie, you're quite a surprise.
Thanks, man.
Your first kill. This is the kind of combat experience the Republic needs you to have if you want to keep the tribe safe. All right, on to the backup warp disrupt. Oh, what? Wait. The drifters are very serious about getting hold of you, recruit.
There must be
more. Another seeker just warped in. Probably part of their search for survivors. You just got a chance to double your kill count. Show it what happens to those who attack the Minmatar people.
Awesome. Where is it? Is there a radar?
Captain, let's see what you have learned. Can you take out the second... It's time to engage. Fire your weapons.
Right.
When you have defeated the Seeker, you should stop your ship.
My gun looks puny compared to his. How do we know how much like, hit points this thing has? Oh, is that it right there? It is. Stop the ship.
Captain, you can explore the Seeker wrecks to see if they left anything behind. Move your mouse over the wreckage and hold down the left mouse button. A radial menu will appear.
They blew up.
Select open cargo to view the contents and then click the loot all button. Remember to get close.
I'm thinking you might make a good warrior yet, recruit, so I'll clue you in on some strategic intel. Our long-range sensors have tracked a squadron of drifter battleships, and they're heading for your location. I don't care how good you are with that autocannon, you can't take on drifter battleships in a corvette. They'll crush you. You need to destroy that secondary warp disruption generator right now. If you're quick and lucky, you won't get interrupted by any more of those damned Seekers.
Alright, so where's the last one?
Captain, locate the backup generator in your overview and approach it.
Approaching.
Activate your primary weapon to destroy the generator.
Putting backup generator. Where is it, though? Oh, is that it? Get the egg? Fire! Where am I, Micah? Cracked. We've been hurting him like barely.
Okay, listen carefully, recruit. You've almost run out of time. The Drifter Battleship Squadron has warped in very close to your location. By destroying the warp disruption generator, you've removed the bubble that prevented you leaving the site. The tribes will gain nothing from you trying to take them on solo. Republic's security services need those survivors for debriefing, and I'd like to congratulate you on this rescue in person one day. So your orders are to report to headquarters now.
Okay.
Captain, your ship is fitted with a warp drive, which is capable of bending space and time in order to efficiently displace you toward your destination. I have overridden the ship's clearance system to give you full access to the drive. Find your HQ highlighted in the overview. Hold down your left mouse button and select dock on the radial menu. You do not want to face these giant drifter ships by yourself.
Well, that is Doc. What is this pointing to? Let's just go. Wait, no. Drifter battleship. That's what I'm supposed to be avoiding, right? That's bad. Edit. Dock. Here we go.
Warp drive active.
You're level 8 in Clash Royale now? Nice. Can we move you? Can. Over there. Good. Crash into it, right?
Docking permission requested.
Maybe we already had permission, but it's fine.
Docking request accepted.
Well, I got money.
Welcome to the home of the Minmatar Academy.
So,
plenty of legendary Capsuliers have started here and gone on to strike fear into the enemies of the Republic. Recruit, it turns out the Sisters of Eve research team had pinned down the exact location of the Drifter Hive. We are urging Professor Tannen to elaborate on this information, but your actions have also drawn the attention of Republic Fleet Command. Due to your efforts, the Tribal Council has spoken, and the Republic Fleet is starting to mobilize a force for a major counterattack. You've exceeded my expectations, Recruit. Well done. As a token of gratitude, the Minmatar Republic has awarded you a cash bonus.
I do play Clash Royale.
Of course, money isn't everything. And I have to say your kudos has risen high. I've also put in a word with Command, and I've been given direct authority to accelerate your Capsulea training. I need you to be part of this counterattack, Recruit.
You need me, see?
Bonus payments and accelerated training are quite unusual for a recruit of your status. It is an honor to be serving with you. I must warn you, though, Capsuleer training is the hardest, most complicated training process known to man.
Oh.
Only a fraction of pilots endure it. An accelerated process is going to be very challenging. However, so far, you have been performing well. The funds you received are awarded in ISK, or Interstellar Credits. This is the main currency of New Eden, and can be used for everything from buying supplies to bribing other Capsuleers. I have highlighted your wallet. You can view your ISK balance there.
You sure are going to start your training with a critical task, Recruit. We've lost contact with one of the Republic's most important research outposts in the region.
I assume that's not a lot.
This research outpost is a hidden site where the Sisters of Eve have been working with us. It's the Sisters who requested you personally for this mission. I'm going to raise your security clearance for the duration of this mission, but you need to get ready. Aura will provide guidance on the preparations you should make.
Captain, I am running different preparation scenarios. Research outposts like these often contain highly sensitive data troves that are securely encrypted. I believe it would be wise to upgrade your ship's capability with a data analyzer module. However, it seems like the Empire's stock of analyzers in this region are fully depleted due to ongoing Drifter attacks. After analysis, it is my conclusion you should build one.
Able to stop because
build a data analyzer
126.
Okay, that sounds like a plan.
The Clash of Clans.
But you'll need the necessary
126. I don't even know what that high.
The fastest way to get materials would be to mount a quick raid on a local pirate den. These are the kind of scum.
I haven't played Clash of Clans in like forever.
Even slavery.
You play Clash Royale though.
Why don't you show me how you deal with traitors and renegades who prey on the Minmatar people? By all means, seize as much as you can, and take out any who get in your way. Remember, justice is our aim, and the tribes reward the just.
Okay.
Captain, it should come as no surprise that a pirate colony can be a dangerous place to enter alone. Might I suggest an upgrade to your vessel? You have been issued a repair module you can fit on your ship.
Okay.
Additionally, you can improve the effect of your existing afterburner module. You should now retrieve the new module and skillbook from your redeemable items by clicking on the highlighted Neocom menu, hovering to inventory, and clicking Redeem Items. Once there, you can click on the items and select Redeem Selected Items.
name.
The items will now be in your inventory in the station's item hangar. This is where all of your modules and items will be stored. The ship hangar will display all of your ships at the current location. You now have the repair module in your inventory ready for use. To view it, open the highlighted inventory.
I see it.
To train a new skill, simply drag its skill book from your item hangar into your training queue. You can queue up additional training or train skills you've learned to the next level by hovering over them and selecting Add to Queue. Skill training occurs over time regardless of what you may be doing. You should now drag the Acceleration Control skill book in your item hangar to the top of the training queue. Now you should upgrade your ship by fitting the repair module to it. To do this, right-click on the module and select Fit to Active Ship.
Get a repair module. Hello, Gun Pro. Item hangar. I thought I saw that. Item hangar.
To see what you have fitted on your ship currently, you should click on the ship fitting icon now highlighted. Captain, your Corvette-class ship is now equipped with a repair module, an afterburner for speed, and a civilian weapon system for dealing damage. I now calculate your combat odds against a moderate-sized pirate gang to be at an acceptable level. As the pirates are outlaws in New Eden, there are bounties on their heads. Captain, proceed to neutralize those pirates and earn those bounties. I have highlighted the undock option for you. You should press this when you wish to leave the station and travel the stars.
I think I do.
I have calculated the location of the nearest pirate outpost. You should now click on the location marker icon in the info panel. Warp drive active.
Oh, we had to click it. Right? Makes sense.
Calculated your combat odds to be within an acceptable level of safety. However, I did not anticipate the presence of corrosive gases in this area. If you get caught in a gas cloud, your ship will start taking damage. In that case, you should use your afterburner and burn through the cloud to get out as fast as possible. Also remember that you can use your repair module should you take damage to your ship, which you likely will.
It's confidence.
Captain, you should now approach the highlighted asteroid colony and activate your afterburner. I have calculated this to be the shortest route through the gas cloud.
Why would I want to go through the gas? You told me it was bad. Get it. Pencil? I think I would have gotten that either.
Remember to activate your repair module when you take damage, and switch it off again when you have repaired successfully.
I'll keep that in mind. What's up, Daddy Son? In the cloud? You are. Through it fast. Fairmount, we'll go.
Captain, there are a lot more pirates than I predicted, but I know you can do this. Remember your training. Approach. Lock. Orbit. Shoot.
Got it. Keep forgetting lock, though. Snakes? You're funny. Here you go, Bubba. Still approaching? Yeah, cool. Can't lock yet. We must be too far. Go faster. Lock. Hit. Shoot. Ooh. Nice. Stop it. Is this not repair? I guess we can't repair when we're doing this. 15 hit point, 6 seconds. Oh, it just doesn't repair fast. You kill that thing? Guess so. Which one's closer? Approach? Thank you for following. Where was I going for this one, right? Lock. Orbit. Shoot. There's two of them now shooting at me, too. It's not good. Thank you. my guns suck.
Pew pew.
These are blasting me. Do we ever dodge one? Oh, we got it. You. Fuck. Orbit. Fire! It's life right there, I'm assuming. Yeah, it must be. Selected on it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Could I have just done it this way? I could have. How many pirates are over here? I guess I can't. Relax. You guys are mean. Is it three? Where's this guy? Dead yet? Yes. All right. Orbit and shoot. You even shoot me yet? Shoot it yet? Yeah. Shoot. Little pea shooter. Thinking a gun would have been a better upgrade. So we got that guy. Orbit. We get closer, I guess. I way too far to shoot it, right?
Pew pew.
The last one too. Looks like it. Are we good?
Great job, Captain.
Stop.
I have highlighted the container you need to approach.
Stop the ship.
You should loot its contents and then return to station.
Approach. Not close enough. Here. Stop. Good all. Alright, so now we're gonna go back to...
Click on the location marker icon in the info panel to dock at your HQ. Warp drive active.
That was easy. Docking permission, please.
Docking permission requested.
Cool.
Docking request accepted.
Recruit, the way you tore through that pirate scum was a pleasure.
Arr.
Not only did you wipe away a blight on the region, you've confiscated a trove of materials. Now's the time to try your hand at industry.
What's about?
Make something useful from the materials you recovered.
Captain, industry jobs.
Is it a gun? Can I make a gun?
Manufacturing goods for himself. There can be a path to great wealth if you hone your industry skills.
Hello, Rob.
You should now have the materials to start production of the data analyzer unit for your upcoming reconnaissance mission to the research facility. I have calculated this to be important. To build this module, you'll first need a data analyzer blueprint, which you can buy from the market with your ISK.
ISK?
You should open the highlighted market tab and use the search functionality to find civilian data analyzer blueprint. Once you have located the item, you should click on it to view the active cell orders. Locate one from the list that says it's available in this station, then right-click and buy.
Is it gonna be cheap? Not cheap. I guess that's the cheapest, right? Yeah. Where's that coming? A fee? Broker's fee. All right.
You should now right-click on your ship in the station and select Open Cargo Hold. You can use the right-click, select All, to highlight all the items in your cargo hold, and then click and drag them to the inventory tab marked Item Hanger.
Right. And how do we do that again? Cargo hold. This. All right. Is it? What? Oh, Not be submitted. Alright, so what am I doing wrong? Cargo. Now what? Hang around, okay. Okay. Oh, click and drag them into inventory tab marked hangar. Bennett.
In your item hangar, locate the civilian
stuff
data.
Stuff for shoes, cargo. Yeah, slowly getting it. Click on the blueprint. Not too bright.
And select Use Blueprint. This will open the industry window. Here. You can see the blueprint you are using in the middle of the window.
That it? This is it, right? Right, yep.
To the left, you can see the materials that will be used from your item hanger. And on the right, you can see the output, which will be your brand new civilian data analyzer module.
Let's start.
You should now select Start.
I'm ahead of you.
Recruit. Your preparation has been unusually intensive, but you're going to thank me for maintaining this pressure once you
thank
dive
you
into
nothing.
The next task.
You're trying to get me killed,
to
lady.
Deep and dark zone where something has gone terribly wrong. The Sisters of Eve research facility is totally cut off, and I need you out there to find out what happened.
Oh, Bob
to them.
The Builder.
Professor Tannen wishes to speak to you, and I've authorized that. I'll establish her connection to you now.
Captain, I requested you, and only you, for this emergency mission to our research outpost. I had to use all my influence with Republic Fleet Command to secure your continuing involvement. After I made it clear the Sisters would suspend our assistance, they granted me this request. The truth is, Captain, that this outpost is vitally important. Even more important than Fleet Commander Vidari realizes herself. The sad reality is that there are so few people we Sisters can trust these days. Some in the Republic remain suspicious of our humanitarian work with slaves in the Amar Empire. It's a tragic irony. However, you saved my life and have been very discreet. I feel that I can trust you with this mission.
Captain, it seems you are making some intriguing and influential friends. Your next journey will be a little longer than any you have undertaken in the past.
We're taking
what?
Research
outpost. Is one jump from our present position. That means that to get there...
Daddy, son, have a good night, man. Good luck with your test.
Along the way, many humans enjoy reflecting on the beauty of the cosmos and report feelings of tranquility and wonder, especially in advance of potentially life-threatening situations such as our current mission. No recruit in your position has been allowed to travel this far or use the Stargates. If you become a Capsuleer, you can travel to the deepest sections of low-sec space, hunt for wormholes, or travel with friendly fleets through Stargates. Captain, your civilian data analyzer is now ready. You should open the highlighted industry window, select the Jobs tab, and click Deliver. The module will now be in your inventory under Item Hanger.
Jobs delivered. We did that already. Inventory.
Time to get that module fitted to your ship. Right-click the civilian data analyzer.
We're just moving along.
Now, you are fully fitted for the research outpost. It's time to undock. Click on the location marker icon in the info panel to set your destination to the neighboring system. Now you should select the highlighted autopilot button. This will start your ship moving to the destination system.
I can't tell because they got the stupid thing in the way. I'm gonna hit it.
Autopilot engaged.
Alright.
Once your ship comes to a stop in the next system, click on the location marker icon to start the info bump drive. This will take you to the research outpost.
Click
I cannot set a waypoint to the same location twice.
Well, my bad. I know we were already on our way. Relax yourself. Sure, never really gets exciting, by the way. It's our passive income, though.
Approaching Stargate. Assume
we're not going to crash, right?
Autopilot jumping.
Jumping?
Autopilot disabled. Waypoint reached.
What? Why is my ship all funny looking? Ship's okay. She got launched their solar system next door. That's what the jumping thing was, I guess.
Far to travel by our standards, but remember your good fortune, recruit. The Min Matar Republic covers several regions and contains many star systems, but most of our people don't even get off the planet they were born on. Even better, you're on the way to becoming an independent Capsuleer, with the right to own and pilot your own ships. That status comes hard and carries high honor.
Why not own this ship?
Help the tribes prevail today, and you may just earn it. Okay, recruit. You're on the verge of some dark depths now.
Very never few played Mass Effect, no, but allowed to enter this place, I get the gist of what you're saying.
Trainee Capsuleers. These strategic sites are almost always placed in locations that discourage idle visitors, even if they're among the more unique locations in New Eden. And this one? Well, this one is off the grid and totally silent. I can't tell you what you might find in there. Keep a lookout at all times.
Captain, you should now approach the gate. When
okay.
You are close enough, hold down your left mouse button on the gate and select Activate from the radial menu.
How do I know when I'm close enough? What's this? To the site. This ship is slow. Go. Activate the gate.
Warp drive active.
Active? No. What? Stop. This is bad gas, right?
By the Seven Tribes. It looks like another fleet was blown to pieces in here. Drifters, without question, but how? And when?
Tuesday.
We've heard nothing about a fleet engaged in combat at this site. There should be a Sisters of Eve outpost in here, but this mess worries me. You'll have to dive into the depths of the site. Get to the research outpost and see what answers it holds. Navigate over to it at once, but stay alert. Hostile action is a real possibility.
Captain, this site is quite unusual, and it is enormous. In order for you to save time, you might want to activate your afterburner to travel faster through it. However, stay alert, because this is uncharted territory. The Sisters of Eve have been doing some unusual research here, which does not show up in records accessible to me. We don't know what the Drifters were doing here. Be very careful, Captain. You should locate the info shard on your overview and approach it.
Yes, baby. Love you too, baby. Info shard, there it is. You're gonna highlight it now? No.
Continue to approach the info shop.
Oh, I double-clicked
it.
That got me to
it. Within close proximity.
Okay.
Remember to stop your ship when you reach the shard.
Sandbox game, so the end is what you make of it. I can just fly around. Click on info shards. Seems pretty cool so far, but... I think I'm really getting it yet. Approach with caution. I'm gonna get attacked in a minute. Looks pretty cool though. Lights. Closer. Chip and you. Okay. And resources. Options, but that's what most people do. Okay. Uh-oh. Someone's shooting at me. What is that? Stars, I guess? Activate my afterburner? Am I doing this the slow way? pick up. I'm doing it the slow way. Do I have to hold it down? Much speedier now? 25, am I? Yes. I was taking in the view.
Recruit, I'm getting indications of some unusual signatures from your sensor feed. I worry the drifters are putting out an interference field. What's your back, Recruit? You're my eyes, and I can't afford to be blind right now.
Captain, for your ears only, I am afraid the drifters may have hacked our outpost. That could give them access to ship FTL comms and navigation systems we've been developing.
Oh.
Theoretically, it might give them access to some of the ships we've installed prototypes in. It looks like our outpost is relatively intact.
It's online.
You are going
okay.
to have to try to hack into its mainframe to extract some information on what happened here. Be careful.
Captain, if the outpost is still intact, it will have to be hacked. It's a good thing you prepared by bringing a data analyzer.
Look at me.
Hacking is a delicate process, but mastering it can give you access to a lot of wealth in some of the deep and hidden pockets of New Eden. Let me walk you through the
process. Oh, I see the green ring. Okay, now we're using it, right? Means it's online, yep.
Captain, you should now lock target on the info shard.
Target.
You should now activate the civilian data analyzer on the info shuttle.
And not crash, right? I think I crashed. What?
You are now attempting to hack into the info shuttle. You should select encrypted nodes until you locate the system core. After you click a node, the numbers that appear will indicate your proximity to the core. You may come across defensive software on your route.
Like Minesweep?
Until you deactivate the fire.
Three. Two. One. Boom. Right, I got it? No. Five, like... Eight. System hacks? I don't even know what I did. I just kept doing it.
Now you have successfully hacked into the info shard. You should retrieve the cargo.
Crashing isn't that much of an issue. Collision damage isn't a thing in even. So that's good. That is good. Now what do you want me to do now? Retrieve the cargo. Approaching it because apparently we bounced off of it. All right, take it all. Close. Stop.
Elder, team, what the? Okay, the site just lit up like. Well, Professor Tannen, how about it? Have you seen anything like this before? Is this part of your search?
Just went right through it.
No, Fleet Commander. I have never seen anything like this before. I suggest the captain get out of there as fast as possible.
Way ahead of you, Professor. Recruit. Our deep space scanners just picked up a very large drifter fleet on a direct heading for your position. I have no idea what you just did, but you best make like you have a pack of slaver hounds on your heels. Actually, don't even stop to think about that. Do what the professor says and just get out of there.
Okay.
Click the location marker icon in the info drive to travel to a safe spot.
Do it. Let's get out of here. Zoom out. Am I too close? Man. Y'all gonna hate me watching me play this game. Hello, Matt. Can you not touch the computer, please? Thanks, babes. Yeah, don't spill it either. Of course you're gonna.
Recruit, I don't know how you're doing this again and again.
All right, over there.
You've really got something now. This data store you've recovered is a gold mine.
You can zoom out like crazy. You know,
the
I saw that.
You just extracted. Looks like it includes
when they first
the
said it, I swear, there was a bubble
the
thing around me.
To the Drifter Hive. Get them to our fleet, and then we can unlock the gate for them. Everyone in the fleet is going to know your name after this.
Cheers.
And congratulations on finding the Drifter gate codes. That is amazing work. The Drifters must have been trying to link our outpost to their network through that gate. But there's something else that worries me. I navigated through some of the data when you brought
me such a worry word.
Online, and it's worse than I thought.
Not that serious,
lady. I suspect
lady.
The Drifters may have hijacked one of the capital ships carrying our prototype systems. In their hands, it poses a great threat. Luckily, the ship may be vulnerable to stasis webbing.
Stop having a seizure.
It down to a halt. Captain, I'm going to upload to Aura instructions on how to fit your ship with a stasis webifier the next
time you're following, Rob.
That will improve your capabilities out there.
Recruit, you seem to be in constant touch with Professor Tannen. I hope she's providing intel on the Drifters. There's no time for distractions right now. In any case, now it's my turn to show you something you're not going to believe.
All right, get away
I'm
from the computer.
I'm sending Aura some coordinates. Get there fast, Recruit. You're going to like this.
Okay.
Captain, the Commander has uploaded the location of the forward operating base. This should prove interesting.
Cody at my feet.
Click on the location marker icon in the info panel to travel to the forward operating base.
Nice glasses. Yeah, potato head glasses. I don't think they fit you too well.
Approach the gate. When you are close, use the radial menu to activate the gate to enter the forward operating base. Drive active.
I think I was approaching it from the wrong angle. Wait. Oh, the gate's like the jumpy thing, right?
Avenging sword of the Minmatar Republic, our fleet, the force that will strike at the Drifters.
So I sure hope they're friendly.
Battleships, cruisers, and frigates are all being prepared for action.
Frigates? What are you saying,
lady?
At
our Astrahu Citadel forward operating base, all soon to be loaded with the key codes you recovered.
Yes.
The entire force will be able to jump right inside their outer defenses. Recruit, I don't usually do this. But it's going to take a few minutes to upload the jump gate keys from your mainframe. I suggest you fly down and introduce yourself. The way some of the captains have been talking, you're like a lucky totem. And I wouldn't mind your luck rubbing off on us all. Take a moment to enjoy the vista of all these ships while you can. If you make naval capsulea, you could be in command of one of these beauties someday. I promise you, they're even more inspiring when you're in control. Aura. Help our favorite recruit get a handle on the might assembled before us.
Is this him? Is this the pilot that saved the research crew and found the gate codes?
Nope.
Captain, the assembled strike force includes several ship classes you'll often encounter in New Eden.
Damn, recruits. It took me 6 months before I posted my first confirmed kill.
You can take a closer look at any of the ships by using the radio.
You're bad, that's
to
why.
Select look at. Remember to refocus your camera by right-clicking and select Look at My Ship.
Hey, recruits, Our crew's been talking about you non-stop today.
All right, Fleet, calm down. Our hero of the hour is going to stick around while we upload the key codes from their ship. Then the Republic has a special surprise back at base. The Minmatar take care of their hero.
Like a headless transformer.
Am I right, Fleet?
The legs.
Captain, the upload is going to take a while. In the meantime, take a look at our Astrohost forward operating base.
Been playing for a couple years.
Type structure. Citadels are the biggest structures in New Eden that capsulars can build. These massive cities are quite the sight to look at. Since you have to kill some time while the key codes are uploading to the fleet, you have a perfect opportunity to practice some of your maneuvering skills. You can try manual piloting by double-clicking anywhere in space, or you can use the arrow keys on your keyboard for a unique piloting experience.
Okay, recruit. The upload is complete, and the fleet is almost ready for the battle. While we're prepping the remaining squadrons, I suggest you head back to base and pick up
that
special item I was talking about a moment ago. Sounds good, doesn't it? Trust me, it's better than you think.
When you are ready, fly to the forward point, next to the Dreadnought class vessel.
Hey. Approach. Day after Bernagone. I'm not gonna take 40 minutes to get there.
When you are ready to return to HQ, click on the location marker icon in the info panel.
Wait, wasn't y'all just telling me to go over here for some reason? Hey, stop. HQ, whatever.
Now turn your autopilot. Autopilot engaged. When you reach your destination and the autopilot switches off, click on the location marker icon to start the info pad drive to dock at HQ.
Nope.
Approaching Stargate. I cannot set a waypoint to the same location twice.
All right, my bad. Is chat broken? Nope. We're going to that thing, right? Wait. Go faster.
Autopilot jump. Autopilot disabled. Waypoint reached.
drive active.
One second. I love you too, baby. What's in your hair? Mommy's just gonna cut it. Too scared? Don't be scared, baby.
Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
Recruit, I have very high standards for my trainees, and you have repeatedly exceeded them. As a result,
items. That was up here,
I've decided to greenlight you for participation in the counter-strike against the Drifters. Operation Vengeful Blade. Consider this your final test before reaching Naval Capsulea status.
Take them all.
Open your inventory and select Item Hanger. There you will find your mini skill injector. Captain, double-click on your new mini skill injector and confirm the injection.
Yes.
This will give you unallocated skill points that you can... Open your character sheet to use your unallocated skill points. I suggest you search for Frigate and drag your Empire's Frigate skill into the training
queue. Calm down.
When you've done that, find the Apply Skill Points button and click it. Your Frigate skill will have advanced a level. These skills will help you become better prepared for the upcoming battle.
Mining. Done the heist. Thank you. Well, that would be me, right? Boop. Boop. Oh, it's gonna take time, look at that. 14 hours? 3 days? What are y'all nuts? See why you've been playing this for years. How many more points do I have? Total skill point. They don't want me to. Oh, I see. You have apply skill point. Yes.
Skill training completed. Captain, it's time to use your new ship. In your inventory, select your ship hangar. There you will see you are currently in your corvette. Right-click your active ship, and click Leave Ship.
Leave Ship.
You should now right-click your new frigate and select Assemble Ship. This will finalize the last preparations and calibrate your vessel so you can pilot it.
This was ship hangar. Rifter. is the one I just got, right? Symbol.
Right-click your new ship and select Make Active. You have now boarded your new ship. Right-click your old Corvette and select Repackage. This will remove the modules fitted to that ship and make it easier to transport in the future.
Package? I don't see that. Oh, yes I do. I lied. Are you sure? No, but that's what they said to do, so...
It's now time to fit your new ship with modules. Open your inventory and go to Item Hanger. You will want to fit weapons, an afterburner, a stasis webifier, and your repair module. To fit, right-click on each of the modules and select Fit to Active Ship. You should then open your fitting window and ensure you have everything you need fitted to your ship. Now that you have prepared your ship for the fight, Captain, it is time to head in.
The fleet is at the gate, Recruit. You understand what's at stake. The Hive must be destroyed to remove this threat. With the Drifters pushed back, the seven tribes of the Minmatar Republic can secure our homes and trading caravans, continue to rebuild the economy, and re-establish our defensive cordon against the Amar Empire. We are hoping that we will learn more about the Drifters from this attack. It's imperative to find out why they have been attacking us and removing the survivors.
Cool.
We've lost too many brothers.
I guess I can't put this on. I have too many.
You should now undock and click on the location marker icon in the info panel, and then activate your autopilot.
Yeah, we'll do that in a second. I'm gonna use a little bathroom. I'll be right back. All right. Undock, right? Yeah.
When you reach your destination, click on the next location marker in the info panel to travel to the site.
Didn't know I clicked on it. My bad. You're feisty. Oh, this is mine? Look at this. Now I'm like everybody else. Where are you going? Doesn't go very far. That much. What'd I do? Oh, look at a lot of buttons over here now. Miner? I guess we can go mining. You're moving, just not very fast. Taxed? For what? Going so slow. Another are we even moving? Because it said we were getting further away from something.